Hello everyone, my name is Lancel90 and welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Online. So, this whole tutorial is going to be a little bit longer than I was expecting, really. So, there's probably not really going to be any skipping it. You see, it'll like really wait for a few episodes. It's probably going to be like one or two more, I'd probably say. Just a guess. This scenario seemed a little bit more familiar to me than what we were doing before. But I'm still not sure if it's exactly... if it's the old one or not. I think we're ready to leave this map. Oh yeah, I was gonna reprogram my mouse to have some hotkeys on it.
Click to warn your crew to plot a course to your next mission.
I need a torpedo key on my mouse so I can fire it quicker.
Use M to open up the map for sector space. You can click on a system to plot a course and set your ship to automatically fly to it.
First surveyed in 2267 pucks and its sister star Beta Genorium. A twin star system with the hyperplanets. Federation scientists find planets within both systems to excellent subjects for radiation and habitability studies. Is this the mission we need to do?
We're here, Captain. The USS Kittimer is dead ahead, and the Renown is beside us. Our orders are to make contact with the Kittimer and find out why they've not responded to our hails.
Very good. So, of course, we're Kittimer.
Yes, sir. I will require approximately 15 seconds to make the necessary adjustments.
Ah, Captain Volok. Captain Taggart? Both doing here?
My Captain Taggart, sir. I'm in command of the Echo. Captain Volok ordered me to come with you. Come with him to your location.
Always good to follow the orders of your superior officers.
And what happened with your communications?
These cadets were the unfortunate victims of a Klingon ambush. Captain Taggart is dead, and the ship is under the command of this cadet. The Renown was escorting them back to Earth space dock, but when we could not raise the Kittimer, I deemed it imperative to alter our course and assess the situation. Captain Yim, what is your status?
I'm troubled by the anomalies in this system, and if they're affecting long-range communications, then they're doubly a cause for concern. Let's do this by the numbers. We've already launched 9 probes. Now that they're active, we can do an in-depth scan of the anomalies.
I definitely don't think the voice acting was in the original game, for the most part.
With all 3 ships collecting data, we should be able to complete this quickly and formulate a course of action. The Renown has the largest science team, so I recommend we send our data there for analysis. Any questions?
Question, sir. I'm confident my crew is up to the task.
You're quite confident for a cadet. You remind me a bit of myself when I was an ensign. Of course, I wasn't commanding a ship back then. Let's see how you perform before you start claiming that chair full time.
Understood.
You can set your ship's power levels to have a focus on attack, defense, speed, or balance.
Need speed, huh? Best defense, speed. I'm gonna have to use the full impulse to catch up with the. Supposed to be spreading out. Oh, it's back there. Oops. I don't know what's going on. Focus on my screen, where to go.
Mm-hmm.
Reports indicate traces of gamma radiation, but there's something off in the readings.
Kittimer here. Are you seeing the same gamma radiation levels that we are? I'm not sure that a normal scan will be enough. We might need to do a full multiphasic reading.
Science officer, so I can't do that. Sure, that was a problem with our sensors tachyon settings. So, same issue, how can we improve our findings?
My chief science officer, Commander Davis, suggests that performing a reverse tachyon pulse wave scan will solve our sensor issue. Perform your final scans, and then report back.
Understood.
Deflector dish is realigned for reverse tachyon pulse wave, sir.
Tachyon pulse is a weasel.
Picking up a transwarp signature. It's right on top of us! The board!
This is the emergency medical hologram aboard the USS Kittimer. I am requesting assistance from any Federation vessel in range. I've lost contact with the bridge. I am unable to contact Commander Davis for new instructions.
Give me a situation.
The Kittimer is being overwhelmed by Borg boarding parties. These Borg are different than the ones in my history records. They seem disconnected somehow. They're strange, but still quite dangerous.
Can't hold out on your own. We have problems of our own today.
I am an emergency medical hologram, not a miracle worker.
Okay, this guy wasn't the original tutorial. Captain Bullock, someone must have activated EMH from the bridge.
A notable observation. If the bridge was damaged in the Borg attack, Captain Yim may have activated the EMH to alert us. The Borg have not been seen in the Alpha Quadrant in decades. Their arrival cannot simply be a coincidence. However, I hesitate to speculate without the full data from all of the probes.
Yes, to do.
I will send teams to aid the Kittimer. You will have to finish the scans. We need to know the extent of the Borg presence here. You must also inform me if you or your crew are unable to continue. The Borg evoke a strong emotional response that can rattle even trained Starfleet officers. A crew of cadets that have already survived a Klingon attack may be unable to cope.
Trust my crew, we'll get the job done. Link the IOTA point to your map, scan there while we can see to the camera. data so we can begin our analysis.
We have your data, and our science team is analyzing it now. Our tactical teams have eliminated the Borg boarding parties on the Kittimer. Why do you ask?
There is an 88.47% chance that you will need my help.
Agreed. Can you help the Renown analyze the data we accumulated this knowledge?
I have 75 million gigaquads of computer memory and an extensive library of files on military tactics and command strategies. I believe I can spare a few bits of processing power for you.
See what we can determine. Signatures detected. Prepare your ship for combat.
Ready for this. Multiple Borg warp signatures detected. It's an invasion force. We're outnumbered. There's no way we can.
The situation as we see it. The Borg are using the Pollock system as a staging area for a larger invasion. Long-range sensors are already detecting inbound transwarp signatures. The most likely target for a first strike is the Vega system. There is a civilian colony there, and if the Borg could take it by surprise, they would have large numbers of new drones at their disposal.
What's our next course back?
You must go to the Vega colony and warn them that the Borg are coming.
What about you?
The Renown is better equipped to hold off further Borg attacks and assist the Kittimer. It is logical for us to remain here. We will delay the Collective, but you must warn the colonists at Vega.
Most missions can be turned in remotely. Click the icon next to the mission to report to the contact and turn in the mission.
It is imperative that you warn the colony at Vega of the impending attack. We will do what we can to hold off the Borg here in Vega and repair the Kittimer. Live long and prosper.
We have to make our way to Vega as soon as we can, Captain. I just hope we're not too late to warn the colony. Are you ready to go?
Not yet. Let's all the stuff that we got. Stronger.
sudden lose 10 weapon power on firing other weapons.
That's to prevent some kind of stacking of some kind, but I wonder what kind it is. I don't think that used to be there. 2.5% chance when system random subsystem offline for 5 seconds. 2% pretty good chance. Okay. Probably want that on the front slot. The deflector array always has kind of strange things that it helps with that isn't exactly very clear. But since it's better, we're going to equip it. Sounds better. Torpedo. Better damage overall. It also has 20% critical severity. I think torpedo is always crit, but I might be wrong. That'd be overpowered if it always hit. Shield emitter. 3.8% regeneration rate. Shield emitter amplifier, I should say. It's not the shield emitter itself. We'll want this split beam phaser rifle. Yeah, they all have stun weapons, that's good. Ship. Shield array or impulse engines. Slower flight speed. Thrusters, 25% speed when engines are disabled. Full power is a little bit better. I also have a coolant. That must also be to prevent some kind of trick. People must have been like switching engines out back and forth during combat or something to
we have to make our way to Vegas soon.
To like exploit things in some way, shape, or form.
Shields up, red alert.
Taking plasma fire damage. Alright. Warps to the Vegas system. Well, the acceleration to warp's a lot faster than it used to be on the Galactic map. What warp is this? What speed is this? There used to be a way to tell. See a way to tell them. I think they probably changed it. But I think space travel in this game used to be way slower. It says warp 5. They must have just done an all around increase of speed on everyone. Is probably faster than my max level ship was going before. Vega 9, begin assimilation of the innocent.
We arrived before the Borg. Now my heart can start beating again. What are your orders, Captain?
Hail the colonies, we have to warn.
Tavril managed to establish a comm link with Willa Post, the administrator of Vega Colony. It's not a great signal, but it's the best we're gonna get. Putting her through now.
Greetings, Captain. Is there something I can do for you today?
We're on the way to the system. We need to start evacuating.
Repeat, please. Your signal is breaking up. Did you see the Borg?
What about...
I have lost contact with Vega Colony, sir. Something is blocking all subspace signals in this area. Even our hails to the civilian ships are not getting through. There is a communication satellite nearby. It should boost our signal sufficiently to inform the freighters of the danger and warn the colony.
So, of course, for the sound. What auxiliary power did exactly. I don't know if it should be something that I keep power in or if I should make a custom setting where there's no auxiliary power.
Our hails are still blocked, sir. The Borg may be attempting to isolate the planet before they land. Your order, sir.
Zarver, can we get a transporter lock on the colonists?
Borg are jamming up any remote signals. It's not safe to beam through that. I think I can boost the gain, though.
Where do you think the Borg here will be?
Transwarp conduits opening all over the system, Captain. The Borg are here. Those civilian ships are right in the Borg's path. We have to help them.
Ship is under attack.
This is good. Drain shields. That's pretty good.
Target shield cut down.
So those RPO are pretty devastating, since that has the 20% extra damage. Crit.
Captain, I have short-range communications. Long-range signals are still blocked. I can contact the planet and have informed Administrator Post of the situation. However, the Borg have already landed and are moving toward the colony. It may be more prudent to retreat back to the Renown, sir.
That don't look good what happened to the Renown, so no. I'm gonna start a free vessel on the system. We risk as many pot. So we can't make her stand here for any more backboard.
Borg landing craft detected nearby. Captain, there are civilian ships engaging them. Civilian ships, you are ordered to disengage and retreat. We will cover you. All civilian ships have safely warped out of the system, Captain.
There's not much to talk about right now. No one aboard.
really not have much trouble, though, with any of these ships. I remember this game was never
Captain,
really
the Borg
hard.
Have landed, and the colony won't be able to hold them off for long. I recommend
the
beaming down to Vega and getting as many people out as we can.
Choose your away team for your next mission. Your choices for who will be on your away team will grow as you recruit more bridge officers.
Yeah, it probably makes most sense to have our tactical officer.
Captain, according to our readings, over half the planet is already assimilated by the Borg. At the rate they're progressing, the region we're in will be overrun in roughly 1 hour. And if that wasn't bad enough, the interference is affecting the ship's transporters.
Understood. Annually tag any spiders that claim for transfer.
No, sir. I'll follow your lead.
That's good. Get your health back up, but it seems to be low. I think the aiming used to be on the game.
That's one of those Borg ships from orbit. Are we too late? Those landing ships don't just carry drones. They can pump nanoprobes directly into the ground and the atmosphere. We need to hurry. The Borg will be in this area soon.
Thank you. We didn't know if anyone from Starfleet got our distress signal, and we don't have any weapons. But we do have some spare armor suits for you and your officer. They're in the crates next to the gate. This code will open the gate. Please, Administrator Post and some of the others are still there. You have to save them.
Body armor, energy deafening, Starfleet issue.
Press the U key to view your status, or the status of your ship and bridge officers. This is your character. Here you can see your equipped items and devices. You can also view your ship's equipment. Equip your bridge officer by selecting them, and then double-clicking an item in your...
Give her this other phaser rifle. Icon means. I'll give them that phaser rifle, but I want her to be able to expose the enemy so I can get the exploit shots on them.
Oh no! We're too late!
Exploit right after I fired my game gun. What is going on? My character is not moving. Because I was crouched. Yeah, this game isn't the most polished game ever.
Thank you.
doing that. Spawn points are here too, I think.
I apologize for Koles putting a rifle in your face. If it wasn't for him, the Borg would have assimilated me by now. What's the situation? Are you bringing more Starfleet reinforcements? I see. Then it's true. Vega is doomed. A single starship cannot hope to stop this. Still, there is more to do. Many citizens are hiding in their homes. We cannot abandon them to the Borg. I know. Koles and I have been trying to get around the interference field. Thank you for tagging the people you found and getting them safely transported to your ship. No, there are dozens more hiding out in the buildings. But Koles and I have a plan. We think a pattern enhancer will do the trick. With that, we can transport the remaining citizens to your ship. But first, I'd like to offer you some equipment. Vega was a trade colony, and this gear was intended to go to Starbase 65. I think you need it more.
Got my things. Retrieve the equipment and set up the power enhancer.
We have lowered shields for the transporter, sir. I will need to raise them at the first sign of Borg ships.
The pattern enhancers are working, and not a moment too soon. I can hear the Borg moving this way. I'll do that. How long do you think you can hold off the Borg?
Remember when we thought fighting a crazed Klingon was the worst thing that could happen today? Another group of civilians has beamed to the ship, Captain.
What's the scenario in general? I think it is the same basic idea of what happened when the game first came out, but I think it's been completely redone. Note that our ability we got from this kid is really so crappy as mines. They work for like Klingons because the Klingons like charge it. And
shields are back up, sir, but more Borg vessels are warping to our location. We have detected a type of generator near your position. There is a 94.6% chance it is the device affecting our transporters. If you can destroy it, we will transport as many people from the area as we are able.
And there will be there soon, Marathon.
Thank you for everything you've done. Even though it was impossible to save everyone, those you did save will be forever in your debt.
Glad to do anything I can. I was born on Vega. There's no way I'm sitting by and letting the Borg take it without a fight.
All right, Koles, you're gonna see friends who've been assimilated. Don't hesitate.
Episode's going long, but I'm trying to get through this whole
thing. We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
The Borg are activating the transport inhibitor. We need to disable that force field. Borgers, so what's the word? Effective? Systematic? Evil. I'm gonna go with evil. The ship is transporting anyone they can get a lock on, Captain, but we don't have much time. We need to get back as soon as possible. We're packed to the brim with civilians, Captain. I don't think we could fit one more soul on this ship. Communications are still jammed, so we can't reach the Renown or the Kittimer. The immediate problem is the civilian ships in this system. Vega's a huge trading outpost. There are always ships traveling here. We need to warn them the Borg have taken over.
Reconfigure the satellites in the system to send an army of warning.
Possibly, but what we need to do is hightail it out of here with these civilians. Of course, the path to the satellites does lead away from the planet, so we could remotely reconfigure them as we leave. The message won't get very far, but anyone who enters the system will get the signal and be able to turn around before it's too late.
A solid plan.
Multiple probes inbound. I don't think the Borg like us hanging around.
Thank you.
extra defense.
Never thought I'd wish I was back at the Academy studying for the astrometrics final. Several fast-moving ships on sensors. No way to contact them, and I can't tell if they're friend or foe.
The Silver Miranda ship is kicking the Borg's ass, I have to say. Oh.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
A cube? Guess it's our time to go out in a blaze of glory.
Held off what we could in Pollux and sent a signal out to Starfleet. These were the closest ships. Others will be arriving as soon as they can.
Glad to see you. There's no way we could keep ourselves.
You have handled things well thus far. Excellent thinking on reconfiguring the satellites into warning beacons. We received the signal as soon as we arrived in the system.
Going to attempt to retake Vega?
I will be discussing that option with the other captains here. But your priority is to protect the civilians you have on board, as well as to ensure the safety of your crew. The Kittimer will return to Earth space dock with you. Once you arrive, report to Admiral Quinn. He will have more information for you.
Yes, sir.
You and your crew have done well. Koles would make a fine addition to your senior staff.
Right.
Congratulations.
Captain Molok told us to get to Earth space dock, and I think he's right. We need to get the civilians to safety, and I don't think I can handle any more excitement.
That'll be it for this episode. I hope you all enjoyed, and have a good day.